why do you think you know, your brand popped off, I guess, like, you know?
Because he's sick.
How you doing, man?
That was great.
Whoa.
I think about shading, isn't it?
Yeah. That was pretty sick, to be fair.
Take a picture for you. Yeah, it's not too big, that.
Oh, what's up, Brad? Well, good. 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 You guys. You too. Hey, how are you doing? Nice to see you, man.
I'm tying this on, bro, because that's for fucking life, baby.
I feel a little uncomfortable.
Got it?
Need shading. No. I can't see it.
I go to the spot. Play your own music.
This tap that we both just got is literally to solidify the initial being the Represent logo, the first logo we've ever had that is an image that represents who we are and what we are. And that's why it's on our skin now. And that's why the first collection is being called this. And that's why you'll see it throughout everything we do in the future. This is it.
Really, you can walk different heights. Next
door. Which one are you getting?
Smash Burger.
Smash.
Who told you about it?
Big Mike.
Enjoy.
Has it always been popular?
Yeah, I mean, just open.
Out of all the burger reviews, this is the best one.
What was it?
This is the best one.
Yeah, the nut.
It is, bro.
The fucking nut. Whoa, that tastes fucking good.
Music sending me under. Jack and Nissan shorts here.
You go first, left or right.
I fucking told you.
Which is mad expensive.
The only thing is, it's blue.
Do you know what the question is?
Yeah, the question is, where are we going to eat breakfast? Because
exactly,
I think we should get a nice, good breakfast somewhere. What are you thinking?
IHOP.
I'd get an IHOP. They do fucking eggs, bro. They do pancakes. That's fire.
Which pancakes, Tuck, are you gonna get?
Dude, the chocolate chip ones were fire, weren't they?
Yep.
I'm gonna get loads of eggs. Probably some sort of random sausage that they don't have, that doesn't exist in England. Like turkey mixed with chicken, apple, bacon, sausage. And then probably a Bud Light as it's Sunday morning.
Is it going to come out?
We're feeling a bit watery because we've not trained for a few days. So we're trying to get that extra pump today.
That's a lot. That's so much salt.
Really?
Yeah.
We'll see what happens in about an hour, guys. Two of those and salt. That's a pre-workout.
What's the price of the bar?
Is the product?
Oh, I know, it's good.
What are you saying?
Ready to get some work in or what?
Yeah, man.
It's good.
I never train like later on in the day.
So it's so crazy. I was just thinking, I'm like, yo, I've known you now for like, you know, for a couple of years or so, but we never actually met in person.
It's fucking
weird. So it's crazy, you know?
I can't do the bodybuilding shit where it's like, wait 90 seconds, do another set.
No, I don't do stuff like that.
Fucking
either.
Kills me.
Yeah.
But as long as like you can maintain size, do whatever the fuck I want.
And stay shredded.
But like the gym community in the UK is not like, I
feel like there's not a ton of places to train out there either.
Functional gyms are fucking rare, man. There's like two or three in the whole UK.
So did you guys put your own little training facility at, like, nearby where you live?
Yeah, I just built one of my house. Yeah. And then I've got, there's another guy who owns like a gym that's converted into something like this.
Yeah.
So it's like, it's becoming popular though.
Yeah.
Like that whole kind of training where it's not bodybuilding. It's just good.
People are just getting smarter. I think are just realizing it's just not good for you and shit, you know? That place in Joshua Tree is really sick. You ever get a place here?
That's what I want to do, but every time I come, this is my standards go up, so I'm like, I don't want that house, I want this house. Time to get a fucking check, though. Let's see what Levi can do for us. You do like a specific split on the track.
Yeah, well, I just put some shit together today based around kind of what we talked about. So, snatches, but anything that I do pulling-wise, I always like to do opposite. I like to push as well, so we can like mix in some high pulls with snatches.
Yeah.
And then go opposite, we can either do dips or explosive push-ups, whichever you prefer. Bang those out, and then we'll go into like a circuit where we'll really fucking burn off some fucking, you know, some weights. Some Spider-Mans, but the plate push, kettlebell swings, bent over rows, stationary, or we can do wall balls, or and then we can, I know you like your salt bike, so.
I don't like it.
I'll just go straight from here to the dips, like, bang it out, like 10, 15, whatever.
Oh, it's so hot.
So, like, trying to learn the tech. I'm like, really not that good at snatches.
Yeah.
I'm like, because I still muscle it a good amount. I don't know how to, like, because I watch, like, my boy who's like, coaches, like, he's coached, like, Olympic people do it. And they really fucking know how to get here and, like, get under the bar. I don't know how to, like, get that down. Relying a bit too much on like muscle strength, you know? Let's go. All day. That's too easy. That's too easy.
Soaking.
Working out.
You training this heat every day.
Oh yeah, I love it. It's used to it. Yeah. My boxing gym. It turned the heat on in the summer. In the back room, yeah.
Fuck. Why?
A lot of these guys are always trying to. There's so many fighters that train at the gym, this guy's always cutting weight. So guys like to train in the heat, you know? I just got used to it because of that. That's why I stopped doing YouTube for now. Just so I can like focus on the brand and like not pay attention to like trying to like make content and like
doing too many things. What do you want the brand to be?
Fucking massive.
Yeah.
Right. You know what I'm saying, bro? Like, I'm at the point, yo, I was literally thinking about this. I'm like, yo, I know you get this on camera. I don't know how long it's gonna be from now. Right now, we're undefeated, lifting weights forever. However many years from now, we're gonna be in fucking Monaco or somewhere wherever. We're gonna both be on our fucking yachts, bro.
Yeah, no, it's legit.
And we're gonna be giving each other a cheers and be like, yo, remember that time? You know, 2022, we were just, you know, a couple of boys went and work in the gym. And then
it's fucking true though. The thing is, we're the new generation that can do that. But there's no one else doing it really. There's so many fucking people that try like to make brands and they're not cool. Like your brand is so personal to you.
and that's how you need to keep it. Like, mine's always been so personal to me.
Yeah.
And I've seen so many brands come and go that lose that personal touch. And as long as you're making, like, what the fuck do you want to wear, and you love it, you're sweet.
Sure. Like, the pop-ups that you guys have.
Yeah, they're fucking crazy, isn't it?
Insane, bro. I'll send them to my bro, and I'll be like, bro, are you seeing this shit? It's fucking retarded, you know?
It's been a pleasure.
Oh, I sweaty that.
Which you don't see. We don't actually have them fits on and just manage to take photos. We go outside and do it specifically. And then take it all off because it's 35 degrees.
And they're like, shit, it is the fucking best. I'm gonna buy 10 more. Mm-hmm. And then you go and do the same thing with your denim, with your hoodies, with your jackets.
Yeah. What percentage of your customers are American?
Just under 20.
Oh, that's it?
Online. Yeah, it's not big here.
Mostly Europe?
Yeah.
Interesting.
Like UK and Germany and fucking...
Wow, that's huge. A massive opportunity for you guys.
Yeah. That's why we're
so
here.
So much bigger here.
And as long as you're like looked up to by them customers, I think your brand can always survive.
What percentage of these kids that you see in London or whatever wearing your stuff know who you guys are?
Probably about half, do you reckon?
No, I reckon all.
I reckon all.
Imagine that. That probably got one of the best views.
That's where we're headed. The land of dreams.
Into 80 single arm dumbbell snatch, into 60 shoulder bar, 40 hand release press ups.
That's a fucking fire, boy. Free waffle from Blue. What was it called again? Blue Bottle.
The usual nub.
Gangsters.
Yeah, I actually took class with him last November. I had to catch him in Seattle because he wasn't.
You'll never catch me in all black shoe, but you'll catch me in this.
What's up, guys? This is where I sit and work in LA. The office looks slightly different, but I'm doing multiple tasks at once. Working, sunning, and also, like, stuff. That's Mike. Usually sits behind the screen.
That's why I'm so pale.
Three, two, one.
Plaster on one of my wall wounds. I have to get a new one every single day.
What's up, bro? Are you good? What's happening? The kid around 6:15 for the workout. We'll knock it out, we'll talk.
Yeah.
How you feel?
I feel good.
I'm gonna show you. Because I found Matt yesterday.
Yeah.
I told Matt, yo, he's like, I'm not exclusive to you. For the first four,
that's for you.
Can you see it?
Yeah.
Alright, we'll do one arm or two arms. Let's start with 60-40, just to warm up the shoulders, and then we'll jump to 70-40. Easy money, big dog.
Man, what a workout.
Who's got it done?
Got it done. Hey, listen.
I don't usually train like that.
So what do you normally do?
Like 21, 15, 9 sets, CrossFit, lighter weight. And I usually mix it up where I'll like run in between lifts.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So like a barbell cycle with running or with ski, whatever.
Yeah, you mix anaerobic in there.
Right.
Yeah.
But this was just as fucking taxing and just as sweaty anyway.
Oh man, that's so hard.
Woo, yeah. What I like to do is like my football pass. I did CrossFit. I've done the bodybuilding. Well, I already done bodybuilding, but I understand the heavy strength lifts. But the number one thing for me is we can all get in shape, you know? It's about the gamification, the movement. And the reason why I felt like it was a must to connect with you all the way from, you know, England, right? That's what's interesting. It was because I saw you putting in the work.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. No,
and the commitment, right? Because everybody isn't invited to the sweatshop. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And everybody shouldn't be invited to the sweatshop because this is a protected place of energy.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, exactly.
And so, well, no matter where you are in the world, if you got a space that's yours, you got to protect it at all means.
Right.
And if it's sweat equity that we're gonna be building,
yeah,
it has to be through positive energy,
right?
And that's the equity that we're building. So from England to LA, we got it in. You didn't complain one time, though. This is not your type of workout, but interesting enough, we did do a lot of volume,
yeah,
that you used to.
Yeah, yeah,
we
yeah.
just did a little bit heavier, right. But then we did the 10-20
yeah.
drop set.
I don't think I've ever been this. How many dips do you know?
Oh, no, to be fair, like I started off bodybuilding like years ago, so
yeah.
I understand like how to do a shoulder press seated and
yeah.
get the reps out.
Yeah.
I just don't do it anymore because I don't like that type of working.
But, yeah.
Like, how did you build your base though? Is that through football? Or
football. So I built it through football. So what I understand the foundational principles for me were, what is the general pop need, right?
Yeah.
Because of my profession, I needed to speak to a larger audience. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, right.
It couldn't just be my personal view. After football, I went and did CrossFit and I loved it, but it was like, I also was one of the strongest guys there because of my football career, and
yeah.
so I would get injuries because right. they would say to me, hey, you can do that, and I'm like, then I never did the movement,
yeah.
so I had no mobility there. So one of my things was just like, what are gonna be my foundational principles to go help everybody? Yeah,
right.
I can do a CrossFit workout. I can do a CrossFit workout in 22 minutes.
And do you not think that's like the best way to come at it and where you can do everything?
Yes.
Not to a professional level as such, like a CrossFit athlete, but you can still dabble in every single type.
1,000%. I love the fact that I can go play basketball right now.
Exactly.
I can go run, I can
yeah.
go sprint, I can lift. Some weight if I need to. I can do an antibiotic. I can
right.
do some crazy shit. And I want to be well-versed because it's bigger than just the gym and the aesthetic. It's about how I'm living my life.
Exactly.
What do I'm representing? How
right.
are my kids showing up? Like, I want to be able to move with my kids.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It's not just... So, for me,
yeah.
the importance, the elements are just all tied together because so many people think just train is all about exercise, but it's really about the mental focus,
right?
Right. Just train the mind and the body to follow, because you never accomplish anything in life, right? Until your mind is made up.
Right.
Hence why you created your company, right? You knew at that moment, like, okay, if I'm gonna be all in,
yep.
it had to start mentally way before you started the printer
right.
garment. You feel what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And so,
but at the same time, like halfway through that career choice of mine, that's when I started like training and getting into this side of things, and that improved everything from the business to my lifestyle to relationships to everything.
Yeah.
Like I feel the physical exercise has such an impact on everything else that we do in life.
I totally agree.
And no one understands that until they get like deep into it.
A little bit extra work.
a little bit of extra work for the camera was on, you know what I'm saying? It's all about the energy that you put out.
I think when you're grounded in discipline, right, it transfers in every other area of your life, you know what I'm saying? And so you see really highly successful people, most of them have to do some type of physical attribute, but we relate that to mental. It's really not about the, again, going back to the aesthetics. Yeah, we look good.
Yeah,
but
it's not about that.
Nah. That's just an added bonus on top. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And then go out and eat healthy and do the things. That's what people are motivated by for the moment. But motivation is just in the moment. You got to still wake up and apply the discipline to the goal that you ultimately want. So, you know, I saw the brand you created 24/7, and I just love it because it's not about, you know, you create a fitness brand, but it's literally the mindset of where you're trying to go 24/7.
Exactly.
It's an always on moment, even when you're asleep, you're trying to figure out where it's going. Go ahead. Sorry.
No, I'm glad you see that.
Like, yeah.
It's hard to make people see that. It's hard for people to understand that unless they do it themselves. So they obviously do it themselves.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, man. I mean, I love that shit. No matter what, I've been up since fucking 3:30 this morning. I got in here at 4. You know what I mean? I waited on you guys. I wanted to get it. Then I had to go train Kev. Kev hadn't got up yet. But, man, listen. I'm glad you showed up. You were on time. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. I'm glad we could get it in the project.
Yeah. Man, this is it. This is just a building block to what we're building.
Exactly.
This is just the starting point. You know what I mean? Then we're gonna get in the block to, you know, and then we're gonna take off.
Let's do it.
Let's do it. Yo, I appreciate you, man. All showing up with number positive energy here.
Thank you very much.
Yo, let's keep going. And them two fuckers over there.
Actually, putting real work today.
Yeah, that's every day.
Yeah.
And then Harry behind the camera showed up.
These all move at speed for big guys.
Yeah.
I've never seen anything like
that.
Freaking
nature.
You're
not freaking.
It's Giannis, LeBron, me.
What?
Right? 6'8 plus. I'm actually 6'9.
What? You're 6'6?
But I move like I'm 5'10. Never seen anything like it.
Bro, you need to start lifting heavier weight. You're not a big guy. You're just a tall guy.
That was heavy, yeah.
You lifted what I lifted where?
On this one.
On the hundreds?
Just that one right there.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I want to be very clear. I didn't see you back, bent over row 100 pounds, but yeah.
Yeah, I didn't do that.
That'd be cool one, bro. All right, cheers. Appreciate it.
I'm so glad we did that. I actually fucking enjoyed it. Until next time. It's been a sick spot.
Goodbye, son. Goodbye, palm trees. Goodbye, great food. It's time to get back to war. I'm ready.
Let's fucking roll, man. Done with the woods.